Today's blade is going to be someone very underappreciated, Wulfric. Wulfric, in all honesty, is a pretty powerful blade, but often gets overlooked due to the other strong blades available in the game. In the no DLC speedrun without Crosset, he ends up being the primary damage blade between chapters 4 through 7 thanks to the skills and damage he can offer to the party. He may not be a world ender like some other blades, but he's a powerful blade when you get him and always guaranteed right after the rock side quest. And even if you won't scale the strongest into post-game, he's still a great blade, and in this video we're going to go over what makes him strong and how to use him effectively. If this series of blade videos is enjoyable to you and you want more Xenoblade content, make sure to subscribe to the channel and look forward to all of the future guides because it helps out so much. So, as mentioned, Wulfric is basically guaranteed on every save file from the Beastly Core Crystal obtained from the Elder Arachno fight. He often goes underappreciated and is not used to his full potential by most players, but actually manages to be one of your best blades early on, and even in post-game, his damage is nothing to scoff at. So Wulfric is a Lance-class attacker blade, and unlike the previous two blades who could do basically everything, he sticks very closely to this role. He has the second highest natural critical hit tier, which can reach up to 50%, he has a very pitiful block rate, and he has a solid auto attack, which of course is the general attack stat that affects everything. He comes with the lowest possible defenses any blade can possibly have of 5% in physical defense and 5% in ether defense, so he is very much not going to be an effective tank or function well with aggro if you aren't running ways to heal or not get hit. Since he is an offensive blade, this isn't a huge negative, but it is something to keep in mind when using him since his low block rate and defenses means you can die pretty fast. He also comes with 15% strength mod, which is helpful since the majority of his damage is physical based. He has a decent cooldown of 4 when maxed out, making him good availability in combat if you swap blades frequently. Once again, trust levels are very important for damage, so maxing out blades is important to using them at their maximum potential. On Wulfric's skill tree, he has some pretty solid battle skills that are all very helpful to an offensive blade. The first skill is Power Unleashed. This skill will increase damage additively by 60% at max affinity at level 1, going up to 100% at level 5. Now, I'm sure after seeing Crosset's insane skill tree and Corvin's skill where he gets that 150% damage at max affinity plus the 25% evasion on top of that, this skill doesn't seem all that amazing. But let me just inform you that before the DLC power creep, a 100% additive increase to your damage as a skill tree effect was very solid and respectable, especially when it was a very easy condition to meet like max affinity. A lot of offensive blades don't get stuff like this, and it's a great skill that helps increase Wulfric's damage, and just another reason max affinity is so important. There's not really much else to say about this ability, it's just a strong effect. Wulfric's second skill is the Preternatural. At level 1, it increases damage to toppled or launched enemies by 50%, increasing to 150% at level 5. Increased damage to launched enemies isn't always the greatest since it can be difficult to use effectively, since launch is animation-based as an effect, but the increased damage to toppled enemies can be situationally useful in many situations. On Morag in particular, who can smash with Wulfric, the launch damage increase can be very powerful, but the increase to topple enemies is going to be more useful most of the time given chain attacks done on topple fusions, or just using Wulfric's level 4 on them. Again, this is a nice damage increase that helps increase Wulfric's power. Wulfric's last skill, and probably his most important, is Critical Strike. It increases critical damage by 10% at level 1, rising all the way to 50% at level 5. Only two blades get critical damage as an effect on their skill tree, and Wulfric uses it much better than the other blade with his high critical hit rate. Now, I've explained this many times in the past, but critical damage is very powerful since it's an independent damage multiplier to additive damage, so this will often act as a stronger damage increase than sources of additive damage, and that makes this skill so incredibly useful to letting Wulfric access his maximum damage potential. This is a great skill and will make his critical hits hit very hard against enemies, and make him very good with any weapons that give him a high critical hit rate. All three of Wulfric's skills are completely focused on damage. No kind of utility or defensive abilities here. Wulfric has one goal, and that is to destroy, just like a proper attack blade should. Let's talk about Wulfric's specials now. Now, Wulfric's specials aren't anything special, but there's still a pretty strong effect about him, and being an Earthblade, he has access to some of the best immediate damage blade combos in the game with Stone and Gaia Crash, which can be useful, and with his other damage increases, they can still be pretty strong specials. His first of which is his level 1, Brutal Lance. It is a 4-hit physical attack with no modifiers that starts at a damage ratio of 300 at level 1, which increases to 460 at level 5, and this becomes 480 at max affinity. This is a very average ratio shared with a lot of blades in the game and is probably on the lower end. The special itself is still pretty fast at the least, and 4 hits actually makes it not a bad option for a level 1 special and chain attacks later on. The effect on it will increase damage to toppled enemies by 100% at level 1, rising to 150% at level 5. Not at all a bad effect, since the special can basically be used right after an enemy gets toppled and finished before the topple expires thanks to its speed, allowing you to get a strong level 1 special off. It also has some area of effect on it, but it's not really wide enough to often hit multiple enemies unless they're grouped up. The first 3 hits have 20% of the damage each, and the last hit has 40% of the damage, and it's basically just a standard and solid level 1 with nothing that special about it. Wulfric's level 2 special is Termination Blast. Now this special is interesting because it's actually ether-based. Not only that, but it also has the Pierce effect, meaning it goes through enemy defense values, which can be strong against certain enemies with higher defenses. Ether doesn't really synergize super well with the rest of his kit, but thankfully Blade auto attack stat is the more important part of the damage calculations, so that doesn't matter all that much. The Pierce effect can usually make up for that anyway. Once again, unfortunately no critical modifier or anything like that, just a decent 6 hit special with an even damage distribution. It starts off with a ratio of 400 at level 1, rising to 560 at level 5, and becomes 609 at max affinity. Once again, this isn't particularly high or impressive and is pretty average damage ratio all things considered, but Wulfric's other damage increases usually make up for this. 6 hits can be decent for chain attacks should you choose to use Wulfric in those. Its effect will increase damage by 100% when health is 30% or less at level 1, increasing to 150% at level 5. Usually this kind of effect can be very dangerous to take advantage of unless you have very specific blades, but it is something to keep in mind if you want to start a chain attack when Wulfric's driver is low on HP, or just get as much damage as you possibly can if you're close to dying and aren't running something like a critical healing medal. All in all, a solid special just for its pierce effect and hit count. Wulfric's level 3 special is Hellbound. Unfortunately, this attack does not pierce like his level 2, but it is a 14 hit special, which means if you manage to get that far in a chain attack and still have a fusion combo up somehow and want to use Wulfric's damage, it can be good. That isn't the most practical thing, however, and outside of that, the attack is pretty mediocre. It does come with a 25% critical modifier at least, finally letting Wulfric take advantage of his critical damage bonus and high critical hit rate, but outside of that, it's not that amazing. It starts at a ratio of 500 at level 1, rising to 700 at level 5, which becomes 748 at max affinity. This again puts him pretty middle of the pack in terms of special ratio. The effect is also nullifying enemy guard rate, which most of the time isn't the most useful thing, so don't expect any extra damage or help making this attack more powerful there. While Wulfric's naturally good damage, this can still be a decent special, it's just not going to be worth using most of the time in combat, and nothing about it really stands out or has much practical use. Perhaps Wulfric's level 3 would feel a bit stronger if not for his level 4, which is incredibly strong and probably his best special. It's called Apocalypse, and it's one of the major reasons Wulfric is such a strong blade in the speedrun. For one, as with all level 4s, it can freeze driver combos for extra fusion combo damage, and it gives invincibility, which can be great for a low defense blade like Wulfric, but that's pretty universal with all level 4s. The reason this is so strong is that all points in the game, it has a 1,190 ratio, which is on the higher end for level 4 specials, and its bonus effect is that it increases critical damage by 85%, which is one of the most powerful effects a special can have. It also has a massive 60% critical modifier, which is great for Wulfric since it increases his critical hit rate for the special by 60%, and this means you can get both the bonus critical damage from the special and Wulfric's skill tree, making the special do a truly massive amount of damage. With a 30% boost to critical hit rate at max affinity, this special can basically get to 100% critical hit rate later on, which is very nice. Now, unfortunately, level 4s aren't going to be super useful in chain attacks 99% of the time, but outside of that, this special gives Wulfric amazing damage on his specials and blade combos, and shines a lot more before you max out and break every blade in the game. It's still good after that, but once the damage caps become easy, it's not as strong relatively. All in all, this is a great special and probably one of Wulfric's main selling points since it offers so many benefits to using in many situations and can blow up enemies that don't have huge amounts of health, especially if you're able to combine it with his other damage boosting effects like bonus damage to toppled enemies. All in all, Apocalypse is a great special and makes Wulfric's blade combo damage very strong in the early and mid game. It should go without saying, but Wulfric's best core chip is absolutely Moon Matter since critical hit rate is so important to him. Any core chips that give some good damage and focus on this are also good options, though. Seems like this is a trend where critical hit rate is strong on someone. Wulfric can unfortunately only have two aux course because he wasn't blessed by Monolith, but regardless, I definitely run Affinity Max Attack in one of the slots since it's just the most powerful and useful damage increase you can get. The other slot you can double down on damage increase with Outdoor Attack up, you can go for accuracy with something like Night Vision, or you can go for increasing his critical damage effectiveness with Critical up. Since his additive total isn't already super high, I'll be going for the extra damage increase. For driver accessories, once again Crimson Headband is a very good option since it will increase Wulfric's critical damage even further and synergize well with his naturally high critical hit rate. Something like Divine Vambraces can be another strong additive damage increase, and an Avant-Garde Medal is pretty good for some safety since Wulfric has low defenses and healing would be important since he doesn't get much evasion either. If you're planning to focus on driver combos or something that keeps the enemy locked up so you don't get hit anyway, or are running a reliable healer, feel free to replace this with another damage boost like Lance Attachment to increase your auto attack stat, or a Bisque Mask if you're feeling very risky. If you plan to chain attack, Burst Symbol is always a strong option as well. Wulfric is all about damage, so magnifying that effect and trying to kill opponents before they can kill you is pretty strong and effective as a strategy. As far as pouch items, since Lance Arts have some higher than average cooldowns, Art Recharge is very valuable for letting you use them as much as possible and trying to infinitely chain them depending on the driver used. Wulfric's favorite category is general food, so something like Cream Orange Paratha can be good to run in the second slot as well for this. I'd recommend running Wulfric on Rex or Morag. He's a great blade for both. Earlier on in the game, he'll be more useful on Rex, but becomes a solid option on Morag for damage and smashing later on. All in all, though, both are good drivers for him and offer some solid arts and animation speeds. In particular, this moveset with Morag of Crown Splitter, Spiral Uppercut, and Twin Dragons is very good for giving you access to a strong art when health is above 90%, which synergizes well with critical healing along with a good fast smash art and another good low cooldown art to help the chain. If you aren't trying to use Rex for breaking, this art setup is good for him, but if you do want to use him for breaking, which can be used for early on, I'd recommend replacing Feral Spin with Power Spike. All in all, both are good options, so let's take a look at what Wulfric can do. So as already stated, Wulfric is really just all about all the damage he can deal. As such, your common blades are probably going to want to have Hunter's Chemistry so he can hit his max affinity as soon as possible so he gets that bonus. And giving yourself some strength mods, just increasing Morag's strength or Rex's strength as much as possible is going to be very beneficial. Support with Dagus to increase your damage even further with Kaiser Zone, and support with Torrid to give you some driver combo support is very useful since Wulfric gets a lot of extra damage from the driver combos. And for just general damage purposes, just doing whatever you can to enemies, his level 4 special is his best special he has, as you've already seen. And even on normal mode, you can just kind of trash the super boss by just abusing your smashes with Morag, which are very powerful. You're going to hit damage cap pretty much every time you smash, and get a lot of art damage. And combine that with your level 4 specials, you can just pretty much just rampage through any enemy here. Now, the Curadil does kind of troll me here. He enrages to the one element that I do resist. So that's a bit unfortunate because it's going to cut my damage by a little bit here, but that doesn't really matter. I'm able to use my level 4 to not only block Ultra Annihilation Flare, but just get some extra damage on him with my level 4 and almost kill him. So even if he's going to troll me a little bit and live through this, we just wait for the topple and launch right after this, and then I will just end the fight with a smash. Wulfric's high damage makes short work of him even though he's supposed to be the most powerful super boss, and you can just kind of see the strength of Wulfric here. Now let's try a challenge mode enemy and just what I would generally do in a fight like this. This is Cloud Sea King Ken in challenge mode, highest HP enemy in the game, 50 million HP. With this setup of Dagus and Tora with Poppy Cutie Pie who has Earth Element, you can actually set up an easy Mega Eruption Blade combo, and two of these is what I'm going to want to do over the course of this fight and use a chain attack after each one just to get as much chain attack damage as I can on this thing. The critical healing is very helpful for keeping myself healthy against this guy. And using the general strength of Wulfric's power, I'm able to get a lot of good damage on Ken. I said the metal keeps me healthy. Every time I get a crit, I basically get a full heal. And I use my most powerful specials whenever I can. And also smash him whenever I can, because that gives me another damage cap hit every time I smash, which is going to be very, very useful. I use Cutie Pie's Mega Eruption here instead of my level 4, because I'm going to save my level 4 until after the chain attack here, because I wanted to get some extra benefit from the fusion combo damage on top of this. But with the fusion combo, Wulfric's specials are going to be pretty powerful here. If it was on a topple, I'd probably be hitting damage caps right now on his level 1, but that's not really a big deal. I can still hit some pretty high damage there with just the two burst symbols I currently have. And of course, with this party setup, once you break the orb and get into round 2, you're able to do a lot of damage with Wulfric's level 2, because that's another 6 hits which are going to hit damage cap. So you'll be able to see here with this setup, if you do just 2 chain attacks on this enemy, you'll be able to kill him, and he has the highest HP in the game, so no matter what enemy you just do this kind of stuff on, you won't have any issues. Wulfric might struggle a lot more on maybe Bringer of Chaos, where chain attacks are weaker and you have to really rely on driver combos or something like that, so I don't really recommend him for that difficulty. But if you just want a good general damage blade for normal mode who's able to just kind of tear through enemies, Wulfric is definitely a blade that can do that. Sure, he might not be the absolute best option for something like this, but he does do a lot of damage and he can be very fun to use because of what he has to offer to the party. He's certainly no slouch in the damage department by any means, so I would definitely recommend using him if you need a strong damage dealer. And while he does shine a lot more earlier on in the game, I definitely think he does scale decently into the later into the game. He just doesn't have much of a place when you have such strong monsters running around everywhere. And the fact that Petroka exists doesn't really help him at all, because she kinda outclasses him in most ways. Regardless though, Wulfric is still a strong blade, and if you want to use him, to use him. He's absolutely worth it just because of his high damage, high critical hit damage, and just general ability to tear through most enemies while keeping himself healthy with something like an avant-garde medal. So coming up is going to be the last chain attack in this fight here. Level 4 was unfortunately used on launch, which is animation-based, so unfortunately after our chain attack it's going to expire much earlier than the bar would indicate, which is kind of why top was a little bit better. But you are going to see me damage cap to level 1 because it is on a launch, which is very nice. The fusion combo I set up helped a lot with that. The launch wears off long before the bar wears off. This is why you want to use your specials on breaks or topples for fusion combos. But regardless, I still am going to have enough damage to finish him off here, which is very, very useful. Termination Blast luckily pierces enemy defense and it gives me just enough damage to kill. I'd say overall the strategy of using a Mega Eruption combo is good against most enemies, and this team setup with Tora, Dagas, and Wulfric is actually a pretty dang strong setup. It's pretty consistently powerful against any enemy you use for being able to do the full driver combo and set up a good blade combo for chain attacks at the same time. Especially if you're using Wulfric on Morax so you get access to the Smash Art, of course. That's probably her main benefit over Rex, but don't let that stop you from using Wulfric on Rex also, because it can be a very powerful option on Rex. So here I'm going to set up the double stack fusion combo on this break, and then chain attack the Pernicious Bent here. And once again you're going to see me just kind of destroy his health bar with my level 4 special, which is again an extremely powerful special, and we're able to chain attack, and Wulfric's going to damage cap every hit of his level 1 to kill this enemy. Never mind, I forgot he went to resist my element. Well, close enough. Regardless, you can see just how consistent this kind of setup is, and if you want to just run a good, solid damage dealer, Wulfric is absolutely a great option for that. Sure, technically there are people who do it better, but Wulfric is one of the blades with the best availability in the game. He doesn't even require DLC, and he will always be powerful if you know how to use him properly, and that makes him a pretty strong option in any situation. In short, Wulfric is very good. So there you have it. Cockroach Man isn't too bad, but most people probably don't give him the chance to see just how strong his damage can be. Or they just like cute girls better. Regardless, I've always thought Wulfric was pretty underrated and I definitely consider him the best Lance Blade. His main problem in post-game is being outclassed by the Lance Clone and also Earth Element Petroka, but he's still a pretty solid blade that makes the mid-game much easier if you know how to use him. Anyway, that's gonna cover it for this vid. Hope you all learned something and appreciate Wulfric more. If you enjoyed, then please be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and look forward to my future guides and content. With all that being said, thank you all so much for watching and have a wonderful day.